Down the stretch we go. In front. Tip wide, and that will do it. And the Blues have now lost five in a row.
It takes quite a bit for the home crowd to boo you at Enterprise Center. The Blues pulled off that feat last night in their 5-1 loss to the Kings. It's the franchise's first five-game losing streak in the first month of a full season since that miserable campaign of 05-06. On the season, the Blues have been outscored 30-19. That's the fewest goals of any team in the NHL so far. And the frustration is only growing at Enterprise Center. But Blues president and GM Doug Armstrong made a point to talk to the media himself today and put it squarely on the players to turn things around.
I told the players the coach is not going anywhere because the coach came from the American Hockey League where he coached young players and made them better. And he coached veteran players and made them win here. So he can do both. So he's going to be here. And I don't say that as a threat or anything like that, but I believe in the coach. I believe in the system.
Remember this guy, former Blue Tage Thompson? Well, he's quietly becoming a star in Buffalo. Look at the handle to score last night against Detroit. Impressive for a guy who's 6'7". He had the hat trick and 3 assists last night. Thompson had 38 goals for the Sabres last year. The Cardinals have a pair of gold glovers today. Rookie Brendan Donovan won the first ever National League Utility Gold Glove, beating out teammate Tommy Edman. And no surprise, Nolan Arenado is the NL third base gold glover yet again. Arenado has been so good, he hasn't even let anyone else win the gold glove at third base since he broke into the big leagues. Today is Tuesday, so this bunch did what they do every Tuesday morning from spring to fall. They met at Baldwin Golf Course for their weekly league. And that lady riding passenger, that's 98-year-old Terry Jacoby, the heart and soul of this league. Jacoby may be just 2 years from hitting triple digits, but she can still hit a golf ball, that's for sure. This former nurse raised 7 kids, has 17 grandkids, and 3 great-grandkids, but she's not slowing down. She's only been golfing for about 50 years, but has a pretty good reason why she got started back in her 40s.
I became a golfer because my husband loved to play so much. He would come home from work and go off and play golf and leave me stranded with the kids. So I decided I had to learn how to play golf too.
Good strategy.
I was only out there for about an hour, but they already had me wanting to sign up and play next week.
Oh my goodness, I love her.
A lot of fun.
Thanks, Corey.
Last year, the Cardinals were the talk of baseball when it came to gold gloves. They won 5, the only team to ever pull that off. It wasn't quite that impressive this season, but there's still a pair of cards bringing home some gold. Nolan Arenado won the National League gold glove at third base for the 10th time in his career. That means he's won it every single year of his career. Arenado's 10th gold glove ties him with Mike Schmidt for second most ever at third base. Rookie Brendan Donovan also brought home gold. He beat out teammate Tommy Edman to win the first ever NL Utility Gold Glove. Well, it is official. Albert Pujols and Yadier Molina have signed their retirement papers. It's obviously no surprise, as all year long, Albert especially said no matter how well he did this season, it would be his finale. Fans have been clamoring for Albert to jump right into a coaching career, though. I asked Cardinals manager Oliver Marmol about that possibility back in September, and well, don't count on it, at least not right now.
Just his voice alone extends other people's careers because of how much they're learning from him. As far as coaching in the future, I think at some point he'll get the itch. Once he relaxes for a year or two, I think he'll get the itch to want to do something, and we'll answer that call.
I do trust the guys, and I think the patience is going to be rewarded with good play.
It's gotten rough enough for the Blues that GM Doug Armstrong and owner Tom Stillman were concerned onlookers today at practice. The losing streak is now at 5 games, but Army isn't ready to push the panic button yet. He said it's up to the players to turn things around by putting more shots on goal and not overthinking. Things are trending in the other direction up in Champaign. The Fighting Illini are now 7-1 with Michigan State coming up on Saturday. The first playoff rankings come out tonight, and while head coach Brett Bielema won't be watching, he does say it'll be good for recruiting.
I think what it's great for is the University of Illinois. I think it's great for our fan base. you know, hopefully it's just a start of where we're going to be ranked. It's a great part to be a part of, but by no means is it the end.
That'll do it for sports.
Thank you, Corey.